emotions that I had when I was first diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. It was about 10 years back. I think I had multiple sclerosis even earlier, but it was diagnosed much later. To be very honest, I didn't know what it meant. Though I was reasonably well educated and all of that, I'd heard the phrase, but I didn't know what it really meant. Then, of course, we all look to Google for answers. So I went to Google and did a lot of R&D on my own and this and that. And it was very, very frightening, what I read on internet. Fortunately, I had a very good allopathic doctor also. The neurologist told me that, see, if there are a lot of cases that are really, really leading a hard life, there are many people who have also managed to combat the ailment. And very wisely, he told me that all you need to do is not add stress in your life. Don't add stress. Do what you can to the best extent possible. And then... degeneration of the... the ailment really is that the nerve cells of the brain and the spine are degenerated. So the signals don't go from the brain to the spine and to various organs in the body. So brain is the controller, of the body. So it doesn't reach the eyes, ears, the ENT, and of course mobility. The symptoms are again very different for different people. There are some people who cannot see very well. The vision. I mean, the common symptoms are vision, bladder control, bowel control, and also mobility. Now, in my case, actually, I did experience all three. But the first symptom that I experienced, the vision issue, was even before I got diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. Even the doctors did not diagnose. They just told me that, take rest for some time. They gave me some tablets, whatever. They were not sure. I was not sure. And then it vanished. But later on, when I got diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, I was asked, did you also have a problem with vision earlier? Which I did. But again, how did I cure myself of vision was actually through meditation only. Meditation, I mean, I didn't call it meditation then, but actually taking a break from work and relaxing and doing a little bit of yoga, whatever little I knew. And actually praying.
You became very weak also at that time.
Not really, later. Yeah, it's a very confusing kind of ailment, because sometimes you're weak, sometimes you look weak, sometimes you're weaker than you actually look, all that kind of a thing. But the vision issue when I had, it was a real, actually it was a very shocking experience, because I didn't even go for an eye test. I accompanied my husband. He had gone for a regular eye test. And those days I was getting minor headaches in the evening and night and all. So I said, okay, I've come to the eye clinic. I think maybe it is something to do with vision. Let me also check my eyes. And actually I could not see at all from one eye. One eye was functional, totally. And one eye was just dysfunctional. I couldn't see anything. So I was shocked. Even the doctor was shocked, the ophthalmologist. He didn't know. He said, okay, I don't know. He gave me some tablets, which were actually later on, again, Google told me that it was sleeping tablets. So then I didn't take those tablets. I mean, I understood that it's obviously related to stress. No, if you are given sleeping tablets, it has to be for relaxation. So I said, okay, I just took a 1 week holiday. I was working at that time in software. So I said, I had some deadlines and all, but I said, 1 week I can't come for whatever reason. And then every day I meditated, I prayed, which is what I call meditation. It's all a form of prayer only, So I prayed, and early in the morning I looked at the sun. Though I didn't actually know it helped. I mean, technically that I didn't know the term sun yoga and all, but I thought it will help if I get up in the morning and try. And then afterwards, after a week or, around a week, I went back. Okay, sorry. Yeah, I went for the second checkup, and I could see completely. So my first experience of healing was with meditation only. And then later on, of course, when I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, again I came to the same conclusion that if I can heal myself of vision, I can heal of other things also with something. I mean, God will show me a way. And so I explored various alternatives, And again, serendipitously, I was working for Life Positive magazine when I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. And Life Positive has been a beacon of hope, a beacon of my recovery also. I mean, because of Life Positive, I can definitely say it has contributed a lot to my healing, because apart from writing about the therapies, it made me read and write about success stories of people who have overcome ailments. See, the fact is that we are all going to have some or the other ailment. This is a physical body, some or the other issue you may have. But it again, when you write about people who have overcome it, then you get hope that I can also overcome whatever it is. And of course, I tried some alternate therapies I could not try because my children were still in school. And I didn't want to get admitted in any hospital, whether it is allopathy, Ayurveda or whatever it is, because I thought let them finish their studies, not because the house can't be managed, it can be. But the point is that, you know, children get very stressed. Like, you know, the atmosphere of the house changes if mummy has gone to hospital, this, that and all. So I didn't want them to know. Of course, they knew something was wrong, but they didn't think it was a big deal. They didn't think, and both my husband and I decided that after they are well settled and all, then we will take your ailment seriously. And in the process of actually trying to make a proper routine where, you know, nothing would make a difference to our family life, my life itself was never really very much hampered with MS. I did have issues, not that I didn't have, but I did lead a very complete normal life all through. And in that process, of course, I did explore alternate therapies also, if I could, you know, try that, whatever. And I found acupuncture. Remarkably, again through the grace of God, very, very close to my home, where I was staying. So my children didn't even know that they used to go to school, I used to go for half an hour, acupuncture, come back home, do my work, everything, it was a normal routine. And I actually, at that point, when I started acupuncture, I didn't even have too much hope and all. I just thought, okay, let me see how it works. And it actually worked. It has restored everything. I'm completely okay now. And even the allopathic tests, which I took about 2 years back, have shown a reduction in my lesions or whatever the terminology for the scarring of the cells. And after that, beyond that, I have not gone for other tests, I mean more tests, because I don't want to. I mean, since I'm okay, I don't really want to again keep on testing, because I think another negative thing that many people tend to do nowadays is take too many tests. And, you know, tests are, then we are not statistics, no? So we can't really analyze the tests. The doctors tell us, because we don't know enough, we take one factor here and there and then go on the internet again. And then we get more stressed and more confused. Confusion, because we are not doctors. So we don't know how the human body works. Even today, I don't know. So it's better to leave that to the doctors and do what we need to do. And so thanks to Life Positive, to a large extent, though you may not agree, Suma, you are also extremely responsible for it. Because again, even in my job, I was always encouraged, never discouraged. Like if I had to go a little early or whatever, that was not a major factor, taken as a major factor. No, but the thing is, you know, it's a package, no? Like at home also, same thing with my, another big factor is my husband. He never made me feel there's anything majorly wrong. He just like a project plan. Okay, now we'll concentrate on children, after that we'll concentrate on you. Like that.
Yeah, perfectly all right.
I'm perfectly all right, sir. So, thank you.